day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. All right?
Holy, holy, holy. Bless this service. Oh, Lord, we dedicate it to you. We thank you in the name of Jesus. And Lord, fill us this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. God gave Paul the power to perform unusual miracles altogether. Then handkerchiefs of papers that had never been touched in his hand were raised from the sick people. They were healed of their diseases, and evil spirits were expelled. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
Visiting with us. your name and how you heard of us?
Oh, just how you, what's your name? I'm down here, by the way, this afternoon. Been on here for about a month, been visiting my girlfriend here now. I think we're gonna stay.
All right.
Lord. To know him for yourself.
It is important as you
go through life. To know God for yourself.
Hallelujah.
And once we have the opportunity, once we come to experience Christ for ourselves, then that song will really mean. With God heals your body, you know it to be a healer. When God comes in your life and he sets you free, you know him to be a way maker. When he opens your soul, you know God to be a good guy. That's what you know.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
When you were sick and you couldn't get well, when you were broken and didn't have no money, you knew God to be a provider. When God kept you from cussing the book out, you know that you're not. Because there is no special use for it. But let that need come, and the power will be manifested, for it is there. Church, the power is still on. The same power that has carried Bethel for 70-plus years, the same power that will carry us through our present and our future together. We might not always see it, but the power is still present. Our text this morning takes us on Paul's third missionary journey in the city of Ephesus. And while in the city for a couple of years, Paul has been preaching and teaching about the power of the Holy Spirit. Paul has encouraged the people about being baptized in the name of the Lord. He has also helped draw others to Christ during his time there. However, now the time has come to do greater things. Bethel, the time has come to do greater things. The power and time has come to do greater things. I'm going to keep saying it until y'all get it. The time has come to do greater things. It's time for you in your life to do greater things. The average is not good enough anymore.
That's right.
Ordinary just won't do. We sing that to our heart is content, but we're not really ready for God to enlarge our territories. We're not yet ready to plug in. We sing that song, we want to experience the power and the anointing of God, but we really don't want it. Because that means that we gotta change. Once you have an encounter with Jesus, then we can sing that song just to know. So the first thing, church, God is still giving out power. And how we know, our text says that God, verse 7, God gave Paul the what?
Wow.
The power. The same power that God gave Paul is the same power that he's giving you and I. So now that we got that, the next one is the power is still on because God has given us the power to do unusual miracles.
All right.
God has given us a all of us can hurt. The power to do a huge miracle. God has given you the power to do unusual miracles. I'm going to keep saying it to you. God has given me the power to do unusual miracles. What does that mean? That God is ready to show you stuff that don't warm me out. Y'all heard it everywhere else. You heard every other church that God is touching and healing for, but you have not yet experienced it. So God in this message is telling us this will be the place for unusual things to happen, which means that if you are already seeking something from God, we can sing that song, anything can happen. If you need healing, this will be the place where God will touch you with the power of the Holy Spirit, and you will be healed. How do we know? That's verse 12. They touch his ankle, his get that immediately. They were healed at it. The evil spirits left. I didn't make it up. That was what the words were. This will be the place. Where you are part of will be the place where God will rest, rule, and dwell in here. This is the place where lives will be transformed. This is the place where restoration will begin. This is the place.
Excited for worship. So
say, I was glad when they said to me, let us go into the house of God. We won't just be saying that, but you will actually be excited. The hymn, Holy, 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 will take on a new meaning in your life. Because God would have done so much stuff for you, all you could do is drop down on your knees. Lord God.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Are you ready? Join us here in Bethel, where we will grow.
Amen. It's now time for tithes and offerings. Amen.
Amen.
Very good, God's question for that one thing.
his great mercy has promised forgiveness of sin to all those who turn to him with true repentance and sincere faith. Have mercy on us. Pardon and deliver us from all our sins. Confirm and strengthen us in all goodness and bring us to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blood of my new covenant, which is poured out for you and many for the forgiveness.
Therefore, with this bread and cup, remember the life of our Lord offered for us. And with the witness of his holy resurrection, we await his coming and power to share with us and greet us with us at the great promise feast. Gracious God, you are holy indeed, the fountain of all things. Blessings are easy as with your Holy Spirit, and bless us to your service, that we may fulfill and see the unity and peace of the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. All that he has with your Son Jesus Christ, him and with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, the glory is yours, Almighty God.
Thank you. Thank you.
holy communion of the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the pledge of our redemption. We pray that you may bring us forgiveness of sins, strengthen our weakness, and everlasting salvation through Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.